I'm going to take you on a walk along the digital frontier of healthcare, where computers and big data are redefining how we think about health and disease. We've long had visions of using medical evidence to individualize patient care and achieve the best outcomes possible. But it is only now that we are beginning to see those ideas become reality. That is because we now have the digital infrastructure in place, along with the data available to support making the best decisions possible for each patient. Over the last few decades, the increase in the amount of healthcare data has been massive and nearly incomprehensible, like moving from the size of the Earth to the size of the sun. We now have far more data than anyone is capable of understanding. I work as a medical doctor in the hospital, seeing patients who are sick, sometimes dying. My goal is to help people recover from their illness and, when possible, to be cured. I am not perfect. No one is expected to be. But in dealing with issues of life and death, as we do in healthcare, we are always striving to be. This effort to reach perfection, to find the ideal way to treat every illness and every patient, leads to mountains of new medical knowledge in books and journals every day, along with collecting and considering even the smallest, most granular data points about a patient when making a diagnosis or treatment recommendation. This is too much data for one doctor to handle, even when providing care for just a single patient. To deal with all of this data, we are relying more and more on computers and a process of which computers are capable of that we call artificial intelligence, AI. What do you picture when you think about AI? Maybe a computer or robot from a science fiction book or movie? Perhaps from a video game, likely an entity represented as capable of thinking like a human. In reality, what we call artificial intelligence is not genuinely artificial or intelligent. The origin of AI systems is still human, and computers are not capable of thinking like a human. However, there are things that AI can do far better than any human, like sorting through large amounts of data to find patterns. And this is where I ask, should you trust the use of AI in your care? And what do you need to know about AI in healthcare? And yes, AI is an excellent tool for using the data in healthcare. But, and this is a major point, it depends on how the AI is made and how it is used. Not too different from any other tool. A shabby hammer is not going to be very effective in knocking a nail into the wall, and any hammer is not going to help you type notes onto your computer. But let's think about this a little more. If I read through the data with AI, and to tell me what to do for a patient, and the data is not perfect, and there's so much of it that if I can't check with the computer to know if what it tells me is correct, there's a saying in data science, garbage in, garbage out. If the data is not good, then the AI can be trash as well. So, of course, there's the possibility of AI being wrong. And typically, a doctor will notice if something is not right. But there's one more pressing issue with AI we've not gotten to yet, the black box problem. In processing all of the data and finding a pattern, it is sometimes difficult, if not impossible, to determine how an AI did so. It is like looking at a black box and trying to guess what is inside the box. Then, after using the AI many times, the doctor may still be unlikely to know how to best use the AI for the benefit of the patient. They may subconsciously automatically trust the AI or automatically distrust the AI. The same way that you may hit the button on your snooze button on your alarm clock and not remember later, technology makes it easy to sleepwalk through decisions. For example, if AI is used to warn doctors about a potentially dangerous treatment decision, using pop-up alert on the computer, the doctor may accept or decline the alert without thinking about it. Even when specifically aware of using AI, the doctor will still be unable to know how to best use AI for the benefit of the patient. Going back to the idea of garbage in, garbage out, knowing that the data that goes into the AI is not sufficient may help with knowing what could go wrong with using the AI. Despite this, hospitals nearest you and doctor's offices you are visiting may be using AI without knowing the imperfections of the data. In many cases, this is intentional because corporate organizations that develop AI prevent others from knowing what data was used and how that data has been processed. They are protecting corporate interest over patient interest, and there's little incentive for them to change their behavior. Ultimately, the conversation about using AI in healthcare is about weighing risk and benefits. There's the potential for patients to benefit significantly from more accurate, more efficient, more cost-effective, and more personalized care. It is also possible that these benefits go unseen, are unfairly distributed, or that patients are harmed by poorly guided or biased decisions. The decisions we make about using AI should be on a case-by-case basis, as every AI system is different from other AI systems. Some may be great, some may be great in certain situations, and others may be detrimental. AI in healthcare is a complex issue, one that everyone should be aware of when engaging with the healthcare system. In addition to being a doctor, I do research on the use of AI in healthcare. I do this research because I believe in the opportunity AI presents for healthcare, but I also hold concern about how AI is developed and used. Because of that, I have some key points for you to keep in mind that may guide your level of trust in AI for healthcare. First, AI is only as good as the data used. Second, AI is accurate, but there may be problems that the doctor does not notice due to a lack of training, not understanding how the AI arrives at its output, not thinking through the AI output, or a lack of access to the data. Third, there's currently no firm requirement outside of research or surgery for patients to be informed that AI is being used in their care. Lastly, with this information, you can be your own advocate. Ask the doctor how they came to a treatment recommendation or diagnosis. If AI was used in your case, ask the doctor about how the data was used to make the system. If the doctor does not have access to the data, ask them to advocate for tech companies to share their data and for better regulation of AI. There's a lot to think about when it comes to AI in healthcare, but it is already in use with its risks and benefits. We are not at a point where AI is replacing your human doctor, but your doctor may be using AI for your care. To protect yourself and your loved ones from harm, and to ensure you receive the benefits of AI, you need to be aware that the quality of AI in healthcare ultimately comes down to human decisions. Thank you.